Well, hello everyone. This is Amber with Story Chasing, and today I'm coming to you from my Heimer Active Tiny Kitchen, and we're going to cook up some potato fries in my new Dash Compact air fryer and show you how I stay healthy on the road. So we need a knife to cut the potato, and I'll get it out of my very full drawer. I just start out with just an average size potato. Now this is gonna be for one person. I actually make mine a meal. So I'm just gonna cut up one potato, and I'm just gonna cut it in nice little thinner strips, not too thin, but enough where it cooks a little bit faster. These are not just going to be plain fries. We're actually going to make garlic fries today. So we're just going to put the potatoes inside of the bowl here. So that way we can smash up the garlic and put that inside with the fries. Get the garlic. I keep my garlic in the refrigerator. It just keeps the garlic from like moving around all over the van when I'm driving. So I just keep it in the fridge. So I think I'm going to do Let's do 3 cloves of garlic today. I feel like it's a kind of a garlicky kind of a day for some reason. And you just need to take the garlic out of its little shell or membrane, whatever you want to call that. So we can chop it up and put it in with our potatoes. So I like to give it a good smash. Whew, as it goes flying. And just do a quick chop on it. Doesn't have to be perfect, just a nice little rough chop. That smells wonderful. All right, so we'll just put them inside here. Now we are going to put a little bit of oil on top of it. I do a little bit of olive oil. Typically you don't have to do the oil inside the air fryer, but I don't like it to stick to the bottom. And if you put just a tiny bit of oil, it gives it a little bit of crispiness that I really like. So we'll just drizzle a little bit of oil on here. Just a little, not a lot. So I like to use a little bit of rosemary sea salt on mine, and I got this wonderful rosemary sea salt when I was in Tillamook, Oregon at the Blue Heron Cheese Factory. I also forgot we need to get something to get the salt out. I like to use this. We also need tongs. I love this little device. I got this with matcha tea, but I use it for everything, for like the sea salt, because it gets it out nicely. You don't get your fingers all in the salt. So I just get a little bit of salt out, not too much, and then just drizzle it on here. And I love the rosemary with the potatoes and the garlic. It is so, so yummy. The other item I like to use is a little bit of cracked pepper. The pepper adds just nice little flavor to the potatoes when they're cooked. I like a lot of pepper. And then we just want to mix all of the ingredients so that it's just evenly coated and will be nice inside of the air fryer. So with the air fryer, this is a Dash air fryer. It's the smallest one that I could find for the RV. So the container is fairly small. It's actually made for probably 1 to 2 people at most, but it roasts a lot or fries a lot, however you want to look at it. It's like an oven. So just think of it as an oven. It's not really frying. We're not dipping anything in oil, even though it's called an air fryer, but it gives you that taste of like it's been fried because it gets nice and crispy. So the Dash has been really great for me. I love it, and it uses less energy than some of the other ones out there, most likely because it's smaller. So we're gonna pop this out of here, and we are going to put the potatoes inside of the pot here so that we can start frying. So you wanna just make sure that they are even in the pan, all kind of facing the same direction. It'll make it a little bit easier to toss them around a little later. You just make sure that all of the garlic and everything inside of the bowl is now inside the pot here, because we want all that yummy goodness inside here. If you don't like garlic, you can certainly skip that, and you can add anything else you want to this. You don't have to add all of the seasonings that I did. There are all kinds of seasonings that you can use, so just use what you like. That's the beauty of cooking on your own. This, you don't really have to follow a recipe, just mix it up. One day you can do garlic and the rosemary sea salt, or just rosemary and salt, or you can do nothing at all. It's perfectly fine either way. All right, let's get this thing cooking. Let's put it inside, and we're going to put the temperature on 400. Here is the actual setting for the time. So it will automatically go off whenever it's done. I like to set mine for about 10 minutes, 2 times. So that's about how long it takes for the one potato. So all in all, about 20 to 25 minutes to cook on 400 degrees. but I put it on for 10 minutes first. Then I go in, pull this out, shake it, toss them around so that we can finish cooking for another 10 minutes. All right, so let's get this started and I will be back when we're ready to toss. Oh, you know what? Before we actually start cooking it, let's talk about the battery management in order to actually cook this, because I know that that's a real concern when people are thinking about using appliances inside of the van. What I do is I actually turn both of my batteries on. I make sure obviously the inverter is on because we're using AC power. And then I sometimes will even run the van depending on how much energy I have stored up in my batteries. Today is a little bit of a light day because we had a bunch of rain yesterday. So I probably will go ahead and turn the underhood generator on in order to get more power to the batteries while I'm actually cooking. So I'll go ahead and turn the underhood generator on and keep the batteries charged while I'm actually cooking, and then just flip it off whenever I'm done. So that's it. That's all I have to do to get this cooking. So I'm now gonna set it for 10 minutes. I always want to make sure it's vented in here because it gives off a little bit of heat from the back, and my smoke alarm doesn't seem to like it even though it's not really smoking. So I go ahead and make sure that my door is open and my sliding screen is closed so no bugs get in here, and it's a beautiful day so it's perfect. Ooh, oh my gosh, I can already smell this. It smells so good. I love that garlic smell. I don't know about you, but I love it. While that's actually cooking, what I like to do next is I go ahead and put up all of my stuff that I pulled out, which in this case is not a lot, but I like my area to be nice and clean and tidy so that when I'm done cooking, I just have to, you know, get out my serving bowl and I'm ready to go. Not a lot of cleanup afterwards, and everything is right at my fingertips, so it makes it nice and easy. Garlic goes in the fridge. I actually wonder if that does anything to your garlic. I should probably look at that. Meaning, like, does it taste different? I've never had a problem with it, but all right, let's take a look inside and see what we have. It should be nice and brown on top. It is, yum. It smells so good. All right, so now we just need to give it a quick toss so that the ones on the top are now at the bottom and the ones at the bottom can be at the top and they can start cooking. Slide that back in, put it on for another 10 minutes and we'll be good to go. It's done. Ooh, yummy. They're nice and crispy. Those look really good. Now we're just gonna put them in our bowl. Look at all that goodness come out of there. The garlic, We'll just get a little bit more of those little goodies out of here. So let's talk about the health factor of this. It's fries. People think that potatoes are bad for you because it's a carbohydrate, but carbohydrates aren't bad for you. People think this all the time, but eating whole food plant-based, I lose weight eating potatoes all the time. So, well, not all the time, but more than I used to because carbs were always bad for you. But interestingly, they're not bad for you anymore. I say eat what your body wants. That means listening to your body and figuring out, does it like what you just ate? Does it feel very sluggish if you ate it? Or does it make you feel bad after eating it? Like sometimes sugar makes me feel really bad now because I just don't eat any sugar. So just listen to your body and figure out what it wants. That's probably the best way to do it. So the next thing we're gonna do is get a little bit of mustard and ketchup. I know mustard and ketchup sounds a little weird together, but I like it and I love mustard on my fries. I have since I was a little kid, so even garlic fries. This looks so good. I can't wait to try it. Garlic fries with mustard and ketchup. I'm sure it sounds weird. That is perfect. On your screen right now, you're going to see a playlist of other videos that I put together of cooking in my tiny kitchen. Some of them are one pot meals. Some of them I've done 3-in-1 day of one pot meals. So you get to see how I cook in my kitchen and how I manage living in such a tiny space and still cooking in a healthy way. You guys have a great day. I will see you in the next video.